Good evening, friends. Come on in the house. We're gathering once more in the Rainbow Ballroom. It's Tuesday evening virtual Vespers. I'm Tom Dendy, pastor of Celebration Presbyterian Church, located in the Carolina Forest community of Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. And we've been bringing these Tuesday evening virtual Vespers since way back in March with the start of the pandemic. And glad to have you. So come on in the house. Tonight, our theme is going to be Help and Heal Our Nation. We've had a lot of tension throughout this election cycle. A lot of vitriolic stuff going back and forth and back and forth. And we need to heal our nation. We need to realize that when we wake up tomorrow, we've all got to find a way to get along, no matter how it comes out. We've got to love one another, love our brothers and sisters. So our theme is Help and Heal Our Nation. Come on in the house. I see Carol Mitchell. It's wicked awesome to have you in the house. Glad to see you. Welcome one and all to Tuesday evening virtual Vespers, and good to have you here. And again, our theme on this election night is Help and Heal Our Nation. And I'm going to start off with a song, but I'm going to give it just another minute or so to see if we don't pick up one or two more. Come on in the house. Welcome to Tuesday evening virtual Vespers. We're glad you're here. Celebration Presbyterian Church extends a welcome to you. Welcome, Kathy and Christopher. Welcome, Carol. Welcome, Jeffrey. I know you're there. Our theme tonight is Help and Heal Our Nation. Got a lot to seek help and healing for. So welcome. Come on in the house for this Tuesday evening virtual Vespers. Going to give it just another minute here and see if we don't gather some more folks. And I think my daughter's getting ready to open the door and pass through. And so we'll hold off just one more minute or so as folks gather in with us. Come on in the house. It's time for Tuesday evening virtual Vespers. And we're going to kick it off in just a minute with a song. And as we settle into this theme of help and heal our nation, I'm going to share a song. Lord, listen to your children praying.
Send us power, send us grace.
Well, he's gonna take over, he's gonna take control. When the people of the Lord get down and pray, well, he's gonna move the mountains, he's gonna make the waters roll. When the people of the Lord get down and pray, and Lord, listen to your children praying. Lord, send your spirit in this place. And Lord, listen to your children praying. Send us love, send us power, send us grace. You're gonna know when the Lord stretches out his hand. When the people of the Lord get down and pray, there's gonna be a brand new song of victory in this land. When the people of the Lord get down and pray. So Lord, listen to your children praying. Lord, send your spirit in this place. Lord, listen to your children praying. Send us love, send us power, send us grace. Last time, and Lord, listen to your children praying. Lord, send your spirit in this place. And Lord, listen to your children praying. Send us love, send us power, send us grace. Send us love, send us power, send us grace. Our scripture for tonight comes from 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. And the chronicler says these words: if my people who are called by my name humble themselves, pray, and seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven, and will forgive their sin, and heal their land. Let me read it again. 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, if my people who are called by my name humble themselves, pray, seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. Let's join together in prayer. Loving God, we acknowledge that you are our God and there is no other. We acknowledge your sovereign control over all things. We confess that we're experiencing some fear and anxiety, but you are greater than those things that come against us. We love you and we believe that what you say is true and can be depended upon. We repent of not loving you and loving our neighbors better. We seek your forgiveness and wise counsel, not just for now, but for always. We pray for the 2020 elections and we ask for peace, safety for all, and your guidance. We declare you are our peace. We seek your will and not our own, knowing that all things work together for our good and your glory, because we are called and loved by you. We declare that the government rests on your shoulders. We know that you, as our sovereign God and loving Father, know all things, and we put our trust in you alone. We pray that you will turn the hearts of your people back to you, and we pray your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We ask all these things in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior, our King, our Redeemer, through your Holy Spirit. Amen. On this election evening, we gather with the theme of Help and Heal Our Nation. And our theme and our scripture, 2 Chronicles 7:14. I'm going to share some songs, and this next one is called Living Hope, which I think we've had a lot of hopelessness throughout this COVID pandemic and throughout the election cycle. People are sick of it all. So on this election evening, we reach out for living hope, and it's not found in any of our candidates who are running for office, but is found in Jesus Christ. How great the chasm that lay between us, how high the mountain you could not climb. In desperation, I turned to heaven, I spoke your name into the night. Then through the darkness, your loving kindness tore through shadows of my soul. The work is finished, the end is written, and Jesus Christ, my living hope. Who could imagine so great a mercy? What heart could fathom such boundless grace? The God of ages stepped down from glory to wear my sin and bear my shame. The cross had spoken, I am forgiven. The King of Kings has caused me his own. Beautiful Savior, I'm yours forever. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Hallelujah, praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah, death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name, Jesus Christ, my living hope. Then came the morning that sealed the promise. Your buried body began to breathe. Out of the silence, the roaring lion declared the grave has no claim on me. Then came the morning that sealed the promise. Your buried body began to breathe. Out of the silence, a roaring lion declared the grave has no claim on me. Jesus, you're the victory. Hallelujah, praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah, death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. Salvation in your name, Jesus Christ, my living hope. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Oh God, you are my living hope.
Living Hope by Phil Wickham and Brian Johnson. On this election evening, we need some living hope, hope that can carry us when nothing else will. Now this next song, a pop song that goes back a ways. Cyndi Lauper wrote it, made it famous, True Colors. I think there's a moral here about folks needing to see the true colors of our Christian faith in the days following this election by how we love one another and show compassion and kindness to all people. You with sad eyes, don't be discouraged. Oh, I realize it's hard to take courage. In a world full of people, you can lose sight of it all. And the darkness inside you can make you feel small. But I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors. True colors are beautiful like a rainbow. Show me a smile then, don't be unhappy. Can't remember when I last saw you laughing. If this world makes you crazy, you can take it all you can bear. Call me up because you know I'll be there. And I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors. True colors, they're beautiful like a rainbow. See your true colors shining through. Hopefully we can shine the light of Christ and let our true love shine through in the days ahead. No matter how this election turns out, we've got loving work and works of compassion ahead of us to carry out as the people of God in the world. This next one is one of the old hymns that I've loved a long, long time. Our God, our help in ages past.
Our God, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come, our shelter from the stormy blast, and our eternal home. Under the shadow of thy throne, thy saints have dwelt secure. Sufficient is thine arm alone, and your defense is sure. Before the hills in order stood, our earth received her frame. From everlasting thou art God, to endless years the same. A thousand ages in thy sight are like an evening gone. Short as the watch that ends the night before the rising sun. Time like an ever-rolling stream bears all its sons away. They fly forgotten as a dream dies at the opening day. Our God, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come. Be thou our guard while troubles last, and our eternal home.
God's been our help in ages past, and our hope for years to come. Be thou our guard while troubles last, and our eternal home. Help is out there. God is with us. So hang in there, folks. Again, I want to share our scripture from 2 Chronicles 7:14 that says, "If my people who are called by my name humble themselves, pray, seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I'll hear from heaven, and I'll forgive their sin and heal their land." Let's pray together. Loving God, we know that you have heard our prayers, the cries of our heart. You hear everything that we've asked, and we know that you will answer. You love peace and decency and order, and we're asking exactly for that tonight and in the days ahead. We ask for your special hedge of protection over our nation and all its people this night and for every important outcome, whatever that may be. Your word tells us your plan is not to harm us, but to give us a hope and a future. We believe you and your word, and we thank you for your faithfulness and your everlasting love. We pray all these things in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Lord, our Savior, our King, and our Redeemer. Amen. Another secular oldie by Simon and Garfunkel, "Bridge Over Troubled Waters." For those of you that have had anxiety and weariness just from all the strain of the 2020 COVID-19 pandemic, all the adjustments we've had to make, as well as a very bitter fought battle throughout this election cycle, it's easy just to grow weary with it. So, "Bridge Over Troubled Water."
When you're weary, feeling small, when tears are in your eyes, I will dry them all. I'm on your side when times get rough and friends just can't be found. Like a bridge over troubled waters, I will lay me down. Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down. When you're down and out, when you're on the street, when the evening falls so hard, I will comfort you. I'll take your part. Pain is all around. Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down. Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down. Sail on, silver girl. Sail on by. Your time has come to shine. All your dreams are on their way. See how they shine. Oh, if you need a friend, I'm sailing right behind, like a bridge over troubled water. I will ease your mind, your mind.
Simon and Garfunkel, Bridge Over Troubled Waters. Know that we've got each other, friends, throughout this time of anxious waiting and wondering about outcomes. I can tell you that God will still be in charge and Christ will still be on the throne tomorrow. Let me remind us that we continue these Tuesday evening virtual Vespers at 7:30. Also on Thursday nights, Sarah Abishakra is leading beer and hymns at 6:30 p.m. Bring your favorite beverage and come out for time of singing with her on Thursdays at 6:30. Sunday worship is at 11 a.m. We do have in-person worship, and we're continuing our Facebook live stream for those of you who need to worship from home. We're having elder elections at a congregational meeting that will happen at the close of worship this Sunday. It'll be live for those who are in the sanctuary, and we will send out the Zoom link. It went out today for those of you worshiping at home. So check your email for the Zoom link so that you can participate in the elder elections this Sunday at the close of worship. Watch for those weekly updates and read them when they come. There's a lot of good stuff there, and we thank Linda Berry for her efforts every week to keep us informed. Now I caution us to stay safe as the COVID-19 pandemic continues and as we drag right on into flu season. So if you haven't already gotten a flu shot, try to do so. Wash your hands, use hand sanitizer, wear your mask for safety and the safety of others if you must be out. Continue to practice that 6-foot social distancing. Stay in if you can, and avoid being among others if you have fever or flu-like symptoms. Keep check on family and friends and neighbors by phone, and then get supplies if you need to be out and they're unable to be out. Be a good neighbor. Do the best you can to do the very best you can day by day for the foreseeable future, my friends. It's not over yet, unfortunately. I want to share another song that goes back to the probably 50s and written by Woody Guthrie. And I think it's a helpful reminder for us all that this land is your land and my land. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. Well, this land was made for you and me. As I was walking a ribbon of highway, I saw above me an endless skyway. I saw below me a golden valley,
And this land was made for you and me. I've roamed and rambled, and I've followed my footsteps to the sparkling sands of the diamond deserts. And all around me, a voice was sounding, said this land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. Well, this land was made for you and me. The sun was shining as I was strolling, the wheat fields waving and dust clouds rolling. The fog was lifting and a voice was chanting, well, this land was made for you and me. As I was walking, I saw a sign there, and that sign said, no, no trespassing here. But on the other side, it didn't say nothing. Now that side was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. Well, this land was made for you and me. In the squares of the city, in the shadow of the steeple, near the relief office, I see my people. And some are grumbling, and some are wondering if this land's still made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream water. Well, this land was made for you and me. Yes, this land was made for you and me.
All right, friends, this land is your land and my land. And we've got to learn to share. We've got to learn to get along and be good people to other people. I want to close with a charge and benediction that comes from, it's credited to St. Francis, called the Prayer of St. Francis. He says, Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there's injury, pardon. Where there's doubt, faith. Where there's despair, hope. Where there's darkness, light. And where there's sadness, joy. O divine master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. And it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. That's a blessing that can carry us for days to come, friends. I want to close with the doxology with Alleluias. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise God all creatures high and low. Alleluia, Alleluia. Praise God in Jesus fully known. Creator, Word, and Spirit one. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. Praises be to God on high, who will still be in charge tomorrow when we wake up, and the day after that, and the day after that, and the day after that. Thanks be to God that we know who holds our future, even if we don't know the specifics of our future. I thank you, friends, for coming out tonight to share this edition of Tuesday Evening Virtual Vespers.
And I look forward to meeting with you again. And I offer you all of God's many blessings. And I wish you a good night's rest. And God bless us as we get through this election and as we learn to live and love and serve together in the coming days. God bless you, friends. Know that God loves you, and so do I. Tom Dendy, pastor of Celebration Presbyterian Church, wishing you God's very best. Take care.